You remember I said in the opening of the discussion that very few people know. I can say it in a few words, I think. It's not easy to say it in a few words, but I'll find, I see that they're there, lurking. That no one knows why, what the meaning of Jesus on the cross and shedding his blood means. But you have to take that for granted. And so it's not good enough. It's not good enough, the fact that you accept it mechanically because you want to belong to something good. It's okay, it's better than belonging to something bad, right? And so you'd rather, you know, if you came out of a, if you're walking in an alley and there's a church on one side and a bar on the other side full of drunks, it's better that you should encounter the Christian one rather than the hypnotized and mesmerized drunken one. But they're both mesmerized. So they're both mesmerized, but it's better to have the good mesmerized one than the bad mesmerized one. See, but the good mesmerized are not those good because they fool everybody how good they are, even their children, and demand their children also to become like them because they are Christians or Muslims or Jews. But they're just a veneer, it falls apart of the grave. So we can live our whole lives in one kind of religiosity or the other and never find salvation. The whole world is set up so you never find it. You won't find it in religion, you should. You can get good behavior, but we have a Christian religion, right, a Christian nation right now that is swallowed up and being charmed and confounded and confused and manipulated. So how is it 88% of Americans are bamboozled and manipulated? But now that the death on the cross, here it is. You've heard me speak of our concept of Adam and Eve, but here it is, a condensation. God says, of all the trees you may freely eat, but not that one. Now that's not much to ask. You have the tree of everlasting life, and you have the tree of knowledge. You can have everything you want, even eternal life, there, that one over there. Except that one. Don't eat that one. Look at children. They always want what is forbidden. Same thing. And they want to put someone because it's a point of departure from God, to be God. The knowledge of good, the knowledge of evil, is church and academe. Not that they're bad. They should have a value. But the trouble is the kind of people who infect those institutions are people who are intellectuals. Every now and then one gets through and becomes real. But not enough to talk about. Because the knowledge of good and evil is knowledge of good and knowledge of evil. The knowledge of good is knowledge. It goes engineering and there's all kinds of good knowledge. Be a doctor, don't be a lawyer, and maybe not. But if you know what I mean.
What do you do with that? You judge.
No, one second. I don't want to learn. I want to just make the point. So we got to the point of all the trees you may freely eat except that one. And so one sin, death through sin, enters the human race. What means death? It means a detachment, believing the spoken word. The spoken word can be the deadliest of all drugs. And in this case, the words that came out of the mouth of Eve wasn't hers. It was its. See? And she was unprotected. The role of a man for a woman is to protect from wild beasts and hunger and impoverishment and to also protect her from evil. See? But Adam does not understand this yet. He has personal relationship with his creator at birth, created out of the dust of the earth. Eve created out of his, cloned. There's a good word for it, cloned. We know we can clone, so why God can't clone also, right? He made us. And so the serpent was the most crafty, and therefore he doesn't approach Adam directly, approaches Eve, and puts himself in her, tempts him. She says, look, I ate the fruit, and I didn't die. God doesn't tell the truth, it lies. Adam looks at him, he says, yeah, well, maybe so. And he was also tempted. And so he ate it. He took it and ate it. And it transformed him. It created a bond, sin. Now, whatever sin is disbelief. Sin is disbelief. Means, and an entanglement with what caused you to disbelieve.